So folks, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today I will be passing over to Geet Madan, who is he's a tech YouTuber. He also works very hard creating medical devices during the day. But today he is going to be touching on Siri shortcuts. This is something that here on the channel we haven't touched too deeply on. It can be a great way to automate simple processes. Now he's going to show you a few of the Siri shortcuts that he's got set up that he uses to simplify daily routines that he has. I thought his video about this was fantastic. It actually inspired me, especially in the morning routine side of stuff, to even set up stuff, very simple routines with Google Home, obviously not Siri shortcuts. But he shows you how to actually go about, being able to create these sort of Siri shortcuts from everything for that morning routine to in-bed routines, when you're winding down, and also a really cool one about how to, message people happy birthday in your calendar so you avoid, getting anyone cross. So I will pass over to Geet today. His YouTube channel is in description below. A big thank you to him for coming on and doing this. He probably will be back very soon to dive into Chrome extensions, which I'm really excited for. So folks, thank you very much to Geet, and I'll pass over to dive into some awesome Siri shortcuts. Cheers, everyone. Bye.
Thank you, Francesco, and hi, everybody. Welcome to the Siri Shortcuts video. Hi, everybody. My name is Geet. I am a mechanical engineer. I also have a YouTube channel where I talk about technology and productivity and just general automation stuff. If you're interested, please go check it out. So I've been using Siri Shortcuts since iOS 13. It has become the best productivity feature of iOS 13. So I just wanted to share some of the Siri Shortcuts I use on a daily basis with you guys. It's something that I've been developing for over a year now since iOS 13 first came out. And I think I am at a point where my Siri shortcuts are pretty robust, and I might be able to share some information and you might be able to take something away from here and maybe implement it in your productivity system. And if you have no idea what Siri shortcuts are, Siri shortcuts is an iOS app which is extremely powerful for automating tasks on your iPad or your iPhone. It has been made extremely powerful since iOS 13, so that has definitely increased the amount of things you can do with an application like this. So without further ado, let's get started. I want to keep this video a little structured. I might go back and forth, but to maintain the structure, I'm gonna try to keep it within three different categories. It will be routines, ideas, and task capture, and then we're gonna talk about some fun shortcuts.
The first one under routines is my boot up sequence shortcut, which is a nested shortcut with two other shortcuts nested under it. It starts by launching my birthday today shortcut, which goes over my calendar and contact data to check if there are any birthdays on that day. If it finds anything, it would automatically send a happy birthday message. If there's nothing, it would just show me an alert about that. Then it proceeds to greet me with a good morning and reads out the weather and calendar information for the day. And lastly, it launches a shortcut called Morning Apps. Morning Apps is a simple, menu-based nested shortcut with two other shortcuts that it can launch. It presents me with a list of apps and tasks that I use in the morning.
If I use this in the morning instead of going through the applications on my iPad, I can keep myself from getting distracted and sidetracked by other applications and their notifications or whatever else is waiting for me to see. Going from top to bottom on the menus, Play News asks Google Assistant to stop playing latest headlines. The news sources for this action can be configured in the Google Assistant app, so that's pretty simple. Meditation launches my meditation timer shortcut. The shortcut has links to various guided meditation videos. It randomly picks one of them and starts playing them on the YouTube app. Then I have Morning Journal, which launches my Morning Journal shortcut. It starts by pulling the template for 5-Second Journal by Mel Robbins, which is then saved locally. Then it creates the copy of the template to annotate on it, and when I tap done, it saves the annotated copy as a new file with the current date and time. Lastly, there is flute music. This is just one simple action that plays instrumental bamboo flute music on YouTube Music. I find listening to bamboo flute music early in the morning very soothing, and if you want to try this out, feel free to change it to whatever you find soothing. Other than these, I have two more shortcuts that will fall under the category of routines. iOS has an accessibility setting called Reduce White Point, which makes the screen darker than 0% brightness that you can get from the default brightness slider. So in bed is a simple shortcut that enables that setting, and I use it when the lowest brightness is too bright for me. It also makes sure the brightness is set at 0% and dark mode is turned on. On the flip side, out of bed reverses everything that in bed shortcut does. It turns off the reduced white point setting, increases the brightness to 10%, which is just a little bit over 0%, making it ideal for early morning. Let's talk about adding tasks with shortcuts. Sometimes it's essential to capture ideas and tasks without actually going through a whole list of tasks on your task manager that are pending or overdue. Add task shortcut does exactly that. So when I tap on this shortcut, it presents me with a text box where I can capture tasks without ever navigating to my to-do list. When I'm done, the shortcut puts all those tasks in my inbox project and to-do list, and I can organize them whenever I have the time to. So my new video shortcuts basically automates creating tasks from a template in two different applications. It starts by asking me the title of the video, then it copies that title to the clipboard. Then it launches the URL to my Todoist video project template, which I can manually rename using the clipboard. And when I back out of Todoist, the shortcut creates new project and agenda, which is my note-taking app of choice. The shortcut then proceeds to create notes based on the template. The whole process happens in less than 10 seconds. So if I were to do this manually, it would take 5 minutes. Although that sounds like nothing, but 5 minutes a week over a period of year is about 250 minutes. The next one is a very useful shortcut. It is actually a feature that I copied from Outlook, because Outlook has this ability to create meeting notes based on a calendar entry. So this shortcut starts by checking if you have a meeting within the next 15 minutes or one was started in the last 15 minutes. If it finds one, it will take all that information from the calendar event and put that in a note and open that note for you to start taking meeting notes. And if it doesn't find a meeting, it will open a template note with prompts for you to enter the meeting details manually. Now those were all the productivity ones. Let's talk about some fun shortcuts. So Let's Make Coffee is a simple shortcut that basically is a digital barista assistant kind of a shortcut. So it starts by asking you how many cups of coffee you're making, and then it does all the calculations and guides you through the process of making coffee. Instead of talking about it, I would love to show you this one. Well, let's get started.
How many cups of coffee are we making?
Just one.
Before we get started, heat a little more than 12 fluid ounces of water to about 190 degrees. For one cup of coffee, you will need to grind 22 grams of coffee beans. Tap OK when you have the coffee grounds ready. Now let's get the apparatus ready. Tap OK when you have your Chemex, hot water, filter, and coffee ready. Start pouring hot water to wet the coffee and let it bloom for 30 seconds. Starting a 30-second timer. Now! A few more seconds. Alright, now you can pour rest of the water until the scale reads 355 grams.
If you haven't guessed that wasn't the only coffee-related shortcut that I developed for myself. I find it extremely creative and productive to go to coffee shops and get work done, which is why I developed this shortcut, which presents me with a list of all coffee shops in walking distance. If I choose one from the list, it starts a walking navigation for that coffee shop on Apple Maps. It is super fun to discover new coffee shops this way. The shortcut uses the current location, so you can try to find coffee shops nearby in any location. The next one on the fun one is Speak Article Shortcut. It is a very simple shortcut. It is primarily designed just because I'm lazy and I hate reading. I mean, I'm also slow at it, so it's kind of inefficient as well. So this shortcut takes a web page as an input and it runs to the reading list functionality of Safari. That extracts the article from the web page and gets rid of all the fluff that exists around the article, and then it reads back the content of that article using the voice of Siri. You can definitely customize the pitch and the rate at which Siri speaks, so you can listen to it as fast as you want or as slow as you want. As somebody who kind of doesn't want to read ever, so this definitely has come in handy. Honestly, it's not like having audiobooks, because there's no emotion to the text. But for something as short as an article, this definitely can do the job. So PDF is definitely one of the most important file formats on the internet. But iPhones and iPads have definitely stayed away from it. You can't really make PDFs except if you have third-party applications. It's a total mess, which is why I have the shortcut called Make PDF. Make PDF is a simple shortcut that takes whatever input you want to parse into it. As soon as it gets that input, it will try to convert it into a PDF document. You can take a bunch of images and turn them into one PDF document. You can take a website and turn that into a PDF, or you can just take multiple PDF documents and combine them into one PDF. And then you can open that PDF into markup if you want to annotate on that using iPad, or you can just save it to your Files app or send it as an email or whatever you want to do with it. Thank you all for watching, and thank you, Francesco, for letting me have the opportunity to come here and talk to you all about shortcuts.